everybody. I hope you've had a fantastic week last week, lovely weekend, and you're raring to go again for this week. Now, again, we're going to be looking at some flowers, but we're going to be moving it on to the next step now. So obviously last week you had a really good go at doing your sunflowers where you actually had a go at shading them. So we're going to have a recap of those today and then we're going to develop it onto the next part. So we were looking at Vincent van Gogh last week. We were thinking about who he was, obviously being a Dutch artist, very famous artist. And we were actually looking at one of his pieces of work. Can you remember which piece of work it was? Well done, we were looking at sunflowers. So we were looking at his sunflower painting and then developing it so that we were producing our own sunflower picture. So last week we looked at doing an observational drawing where we used shading, we used drew the outline of the sunflowers, and then we added the shading to make our shading 3D, thinking about where we would make aspects darker, where aspects would be lighter. So this is the one obviously you produced last week, similar to this one that I've got here. So you obviously had a go. Now I haven't finished it, but obviously you will have had a go at finishing it. Now if you haven't had a finish at all, that could be something you could start by doing first of all, is finishing that full sunflower and then moving on to what we're going to do next. So now we've had a go at adding shade and using pencil, we're going to now think about how we're going to make it so we can add a colour drawing. So for this you will need you might need your picture out that you drew last time to help you. You'll need some cut pencils, a rubber in case you do it wrong, some colouring pencils to start to add the detail. Now before we can obviously start doing any colouring, we first of all are going to need to draw the outline of our sunflower. So we're going to follow the same idea as what we did last time and get to the same shape, but instead of actually doing it in colouring it and shading it in pencil, we will then add we will then do it in colouring pencil. So we're going to need to draw the outline. So again, I'm doing it in pen just so it stands out. However, you should do it in pencil just in case you do anything wrong so that you can rub it out. So I'll just show you my piece of paper. So again, the middle part you're going to need to do wibbly wobbly. So I'm going to do a nice big one, wibbly wobbly circle at in the middle. I'm then going to practice putting on my leaves like I did last time. Again, if you need to practice these first of all, please practice them first before doing them onto your piece of paper. So once you have completed the inside layer, you can add your second layer, and just as we've done it before, if you finish your second layer, you can add your third layer on so it looks something like this. Now we had a go at doing these last time. If you are unsure, please have a look at the video from last time and as I break it down into a step-by-step process. Now you might also, I have done it so that I have got one big sunflower at the top. I'm also going to do another smaller sunflower here for you to have a look at. So again, same idea, all I'm going to do is just make it a little bit smaller. So if I start by making my circle a little bit smaller in the middle, then it will make my sunflowers, and I could do smaller lip petals, again making sure that they all join up. And I will do the first layer, then the second layer, then the third layer. So if you want to pause the video now, you can get to the point where you can have both your flowers drawn. So now you should have had a chance to have a go at drawing both your sunflowers. One maybe slightly bigger and one maybe slightly smaller. So you'll get to this point. Once you've got to this point, we're going to now start to have a look at adding some colour to it. So have a look at the colours on the picture in front of you on the screen and see what colours you're going to need. So it's going to be predominantly yellows, orange, brown, maybe some black and some green, maybe different shades of green. Okay, so now what we're going to have a look at doing is we're going to start to add some colour. Now I have just got some colouring pencils that I've made sure are nice and sharp for everything to go. However, I know some of you might have some paints or some pastels, so you could also do it with that as well. So I'm going to show you how to do it using colouring pencils, but again it's the same technique if you're using pastels or paint, it's just obviously you'll have to maybe blend them a little bit more. So I'm going to start first of all with the inside of my petals. So I'm not going to do the middle yet, I'm just going to do the inside. So using different colours, you'll need to add it. So what I would do first is, first of all, just do a nice light yellow on your colours just to get the background. So just do a nice shaded, don't press on too much because I don't want it too dark. I just want to have a nice light shading like that. Then I will then use maybe a dark yellow, and I'll start. So where I was darker before, going on around the outside of the petals, that is where I'm going to have a go at darkening up around the outside of the petals and by the bottom here. So that it's starting to, you might also put a few darker streaks going up the petals. Once I've had a go at doing it with a darker yellow, I'm going to add a little bit of orange. I'm not going to go too dark with my orange, just dark enough, so just around the outside, using the same strokes of what I'd used when I did my shading with my pencil. So around the outside and then around the bottom. And I might just follow the petals to pull the petals up. I might need to add some more yellowing just to blend it together, so that it starts to make it looking a little bit more 3D. So again, try to follow the shape of the petal so it looks something like this. Just hold it up so you can see it. So that you can see that it's darker around the outside and lighter in the middle. So have a go at doing a couple petals. I'm going to have a go at doing a few. So if you want to pause the video now, have a go at doing one maybe on a practice paper and then having a look at mine. I'm going to do a few more so you can see them. Okay, once you've had a go at doing them so that yours looks something like mine, obviously you'll have had a chance to do the full first layer, and again you can see where I've done lighter in the middle and I've done darker around the outside, just like I did when I was doing my shading one. I'm putting the darker orange around where the darkness is. Now when I go to do my second layer, again this layer needs to be darker, so now we could go predominantly more onto orange, and maybe you could have a little bit of red in there as well, because you can see that there's some redness, maybe some brown in there as well. So I'm going to start nice and dark in the center of the in the middle of the second petal. So if I'm just going to bend this. Okay, so I'm going to start to look at my second layer of petals. So again, near the bottom and near the outside, I'm going to go darker. Now this time, I'm going to do my darkness first of all using my orange. So I'm going to get my orange darkness first and around the edge. Again, using the single lines. And I'm going to use my darker yellow to blend in the orange in a little bit more. Obviously if you're using paint or pastels, you'll be able to use your finger and blend that a little bit more together, but obviously I'm just using pencil. So your second layer needs to be darker, so please make sure you've got your dark colors with you so that it looks something a little bit like that, and you can see it is darker. So I'm going to do another example. So nice and dark at the bottom, little lines following the shape of the petal. Don't do too much of the darker colour first of all. You can always add more dark in, but you can't take darkness off. So put your orange on, then go back to your yellow on, then go back to your orange to add your details so that it's starting to look something a little bit like this. Okay, so have a go at doing that with your second layer and then I will show you mine example after. Okay, so once you have had a go at doing the second layer, it should look starts look something a little bit like this. So you've got your inside layer of petals, which is a lighter layer, your next layer of petals, which is a slightly darker layer with maybe predominantly orange, and then you can have a go at doing your final layer. Now for your final layer, I'd probably add some more browns in it to make it just to set it further back so it looks a little bit more 3D. So there might not be many on your final layer, so I will use brown just to add my dark bits in first. Remember, don't go too dark because you can always go darker. And then I might add a little bit of orange in there as well, following this shape, and then finally add some yellow on the top. So just to blend it, you might need to put a bit more orange in, just to blend it together so you can see that there is a darker petal there. So have a go now at doing your final layer, just adding those dark shading, remember where the darkness goes, and then you will have finished the outside petals of your. Okay, so it should be starting to look a little bit more like this. If you find that you need to add some brown onto your second layer petals in the middle where it joins the first layer, please add a little bit of brown just to add some more effect to it. Now don't put too much brown in because we want it to be mainly yellows and orange, but just keep turning your page just to add a little bit extra detail to the bottom part. You may also want to as well just to do it to your top layer, just to add a little bit of extra detail. So just following the shape of the petal to add in your lines and following up the petal. So it looks starting to look something like this. So once you've had a go at doing that, so pause the video, have a go at doing that, and then I'll show you how we're going to do the inside part of it. Okay, so looking at the inside of your petal, if we have a look at our one that we did last week where we shaded the inside of it, you can see that it's almost got a ring. So first of all, using a pencil, I'd like you to draw your inside ring inside of your the middle part. So I'm just going to do that nice and quickly. So it looks something a little bit like that. So I've got my middle circle inside my outside circle. Now what we can then see is you can decide now whether you want to do browns, or you can do reds or blacks. Obviously there's two different sunflowers on that picture, and you can do it, but you're going to do a very similar idea. So I'm going to actually use more greens and browns for my middle to do this inside part here. So just like we did last time, I'm going to use a brown and I'm going to do the inside part. So I'm going to do a circle in the middle, and then I'm going to break these almost looking like eyelashes, turning my page if I need to. So I'm going to do it one brown, and then going to get a different brown, add my next layer in. I might add a little bit of red, I'm going to do some little orange in there as well. So adding that detail to the middle. Then I'm going to do lots of little dashes. So just to add the effect, I'm going to do lots of little, almost like dashes, dots or dashes. I'm going to use some lighter colours first. So I'm going to use some oranges first. Then I'm going to might add some browns. So again, just lots and lots of little dashes. I might then add some darker colours, so just to darken it up a little bit. So I'm starting with the lighter colours and I'm getting darker. So I'm trying to cover all the whiteness, or nearly all the whiteness, by adding lots and lots of little dashes. So you can see there it's starting to build up. I'm just doing lots and lots and lots of little dashes. But again, start with your darker colours, your lightest colours, and then build up to your darkest colours. Okay, so once you've done lots of dots, it should be starting to look like this. Your dots and your dashes can go in all different directions to really cover up. What I would then just do with your darker colour, your brown or your black, just around the outside, I just add some almost drawing like curls, just by the outside, just to darken the inside of your circle off. So just around that part there. And I would also do a little bit around this middle part. Now you don't want it to look completely different, so you might have to just add a little bit more dots and dashes everywhere else, and you should have your finished flower that looks something like this. Okay, so once you've got your finished flower that looks something a little bit like this, You may then decide to do your second flower. Again, you could do it using these colours. You could also go more for a brown or an orange or black in the centre, so you can have a go at doing this. Now, once you've had a go at doing this, you can either choose to leave it like this, or what might be quite nice is just to add the background effect. So you get a few different greens or blacks or whatever colour background that you'd like to do, and to shade it really nice and carefully. So in order to do this, I'm going to put my pencil not upright, I'm going to put it on the side, and I'm going to very carefully put it at an angle, and I'm just going to shade, trying to keep it all in the same direction so that it all looks the same. So I'm going to shade all the way inside the gaps. And I'm going to, again, I'm keeping it all in the same direction. I'm not doing one way and then the other way. It's all in the same direction. And that'll get that look that it looks like on the screen as well, on that picture. So again, try and keep your hand in the same direction. Obviously, some bits will be a little bit trickier than other bits, but the best you can to keep it on. Now, once I've done it in one green, shade of green, I might then get a different shade of green and have a go at doing it with a different shade. Okay, so I'm going to pick up a different shade of green and now have a go at doing exactly the same method and the exact same style. Okay, so using a different colour, now you can do the same, following the same technique. Don't all everywhere, but just little bits and bobs just to add that in. Then use a different shade. I might go for a dark green this time. Again, following the same pattern, the same movement, to add that in. I might add a little bit of brown in just to add a little bit of extra detail. Again, following the same, I'm not changing the direction, so it's starting to look something like this. So once you've had a go at doing it all, you should have a completed picture of you. So you've got, from last week, you've got one which looks like this, which is all completed, and then from this week you'll have one which has got some colour on as well. Have fun, and obviously it's all new, you might not get it straight away, but have a practice first, and then I'd love to see some of your work on Seesaw.